What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about getting started with OSD Automate, which is new within OSD Cloud. I'm pretty excited about this, so let's get right into it. All right, so we're getting started with OSD Automate, which is part of the OSD Cloud module. So let's just get right into it. So I'm inside my MDT server because this is where I started my OSD Cloud journey. I'm going to click on the Start menu. I am going to locate Windows PowerShell ISE, and I'm going to right-click on it, and we're going to go into More. We're going to locate and click on Run as an Administrator. Awesome. Now, first command that we need to run is the following, Start OSD Cloud. Awesome. We're going to click F8 to run it and let it run. This is what's going to pop up. This is not what we need. We're going to close this. And within the output, scroll all the way to the top because what we are looking for is the default configuration, which is the Start OSD Cloud GUI.json. That's the path that we need to get into to get a copy of that file. So on the desktop, I am going to open up the File Explorer. I am going to go into the C drive. Within the C drive, let's go into Users. I'm going to go into My User Profile. And I'm going to go into the app data folder. Now, the app data folder is hidden, so hopefully you guys know how to unhide it, you know, to see it. So we're going to go into that folder. Within here, we're going to go into the local folder. Within the local folder, go into the temp folder. And we're going to scroll all the way down until we locate our Start OSD Cloud GUI.json file. Now, we need to make a copy of this, copy it, paste it somewhere because we are going to be using it pretty soon. And let's head back into our PowerShell ISE and we're going to run the following command. I'm going to set my OSD Cloud template to the following. This is my production. If you have a bunch of, you know, templates, I have one for development, for testing, and for production. So I'm going to set my default one to this. Awesome, run it. Now the next command that we're going to run is the following. We're going to create a new OSD Cloud workspace with a switch of workspace path. And this is the path that I want to create this workspace into. We're going to run the command, give it some time. Once it's done, it's going to output the following. Awesome. Now on the desktop, I'm going to open up the File Explorer. We're going to go into the location of where you just created that workspace. For me, I went into my D drive. I'm going to go into the BTNHD OSD folder. I am going to go into the OSD Cloud folder. I am going to go into the Automate folder, and I'm going to drop that JSON file in there. Boom. Now, the instructions online is a little weird. I try to follow it, and it looks like it was here, but you also have to take this file and drop it into the media folder. So you see where it says media, double-click on that folder and drop that JSON file in there. Okay, now you are able to make modifications on this file. So we're going to right click on it. We're going to pick Notepad++. Most likely you have Notepad. So just pick your favorite editor and just open this file into that editor. This is everything that you have as a default out of the box. When I read the instructions online on the OSD Cloud portal, it basically gave you a nice little template, which I copied and pasted. And the only thing that I changed was the brand. But you're able to just make all the modifications. It's up to you. Just save the file, close the file. Once you close the file, let's head back into PowerShell ISE. And we are going to run the following command. Boom. Edit OSD Cloud WinPE with a switch of PS module copy OSD and another switch of Start OSD Cloud GUI. We're going to run that. And, you know, once it's done, you're going to get the following output. And that's it. That's it. That's how you created. I think at the end of the video, I'm going to show you guys a demo of me actually taking the ISO that this was created, creating a virtual machine, mounting it, booting into that ISO. And you're going to see a demo of the operating system being pulled down online, re-imaging the machine, deploying it. It was pretty cool. This technology is pretty awesome. I definitely need to play around with it a lot more. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.